इक्वल्स Always you have to start a function either with plus or equals. See, before you start the function, for example, let me show you very small functions. So like that, here I'm going to do equals sum. So once if I type equals and type the first two letter of your function, just first type two letters of your function equals SU, so that what happens automatically, the list of the formulas or the list of the functions which are starts with SU will be listed there. In that, use the down arrow mark or up arrow mark. Use the down arrow mark or up arrow mark, and then use the tab key to select the particular function. Is that clear? See here. So let me have some numbers here. I have some numbers right here. For this particular range, I want to do sum. And I told you, like, select this, and if you give auto sum, you'll be getting the total and all. But here, little different equals SU. So always I started a function with equals SU so that it lists the functions or the formulas which are starts with SU. Come down, down. So I'm going to use this particular function sum. So that is nothing but adds all the numbers in a range of cells. What is that? Sum is nothing but used to add all the numbers in a range of cells. So select the function. See, once you select the function, you will be having like this. Number one, comma, number two, comma, but number two will be there in the square bracket. So what is that meaning? Number one, it should be come under percent, you should have some value. Okay. So if you want to do, at least you should have a range or a value. One number should be there for doing this particular function. Number two means you can have either a range or any some set of numbers. Option two, second number. For example, this one range you think. You should have number two. And what is that square bracket means? That is nothing but optional. Square bracket is nothing but stands for optional. You should have at least one value. If you don't have number two, it's not a problem. But at least you should have one. It is optional. And what is that dot? Number three, number four, number five can keep on going. Okay. So see here, let me come back here. Number one. Let me select this range. Okay. Once if I select the range, and next, what we are having, comma, right? If you want give comma, you can give. But if you have the number two value, then only you should give comma. If you don't have number two, then you should not give commas at all. See, number two, if you desire, if not there, then close, erase that, and what I'm having finally close bracket. So let me show you once again. Equals SU, list of the formulas will be listed. Come down, use tab key and select the particular function. Number one, this is the number one range. Okay, number two, I don't have. However, it is in the square bracket. Option, leave it off. And then see what is the final one? Close bracket. So this is how we have to start a function. Okay, so now. So we are going to see some set of functions. Mathematical functions. So sum maximum minimum average okay and then round trunk mode floor see so take a list of these functions. So what are the functions we are going to see? Mathematical functions: sum, maximum, minimum, average, round, trunk, ceiling, floor, and mode. Taken and add with this product also. Okay, now let me come back here. So first, let me make you clear about the basic algorithms like which we use for BODMAS. Bracket, order, division, multiplication, addition, and subtractions. Okay. So here, this is used for addition. Subtraction. Sorry. This is multiplication, subtraction, this is multiplication, and this is nothing but called as division. This is for concatenate, and this is for squares. Okay, so these are the basic things where we can do it: addition, subtraction, multiplication, forward slashes for division, and this for concatenate, and arrow mark. This is nothing but for squares. So now let's see here. Let me take a data, a small data, what we have done already for the last class, right? Student info, conditional formatting we have done, right? Same like that. Let us take a small data. So whatever you have done and saved in the last class, right? Take that content. So take that particular content which we have shared in the last class. Once you have taken, see here. First, we are going to see sum. So what we are going to find out? Total. Equals. SU. Come down, use the tab key to select the function. Why? Because if you use mouse, sometimes it will be a problem. Instead of selecting, you would have triple clicked or single click, it may have some problem and you will be submitting the formula directly. Okay, use the tab key, so it will be very easy. So even if it is a big one also, just using tab, automatically the function will be selected. Okay, so use tab key. And before you are using the tab, you just read that condition, what that sum function will do. What that sum will do, adds all the numbers in a range of cells, okay, given as arguments, like adds all the range of, all the numbers in a range of cells. So use tab key and select the function. Number one, close bracket. So however, if I give comma means I should have number 2, which is highlighting the right, but they have mentioned in the square bracket, okay, which is optional. You should have at least one range or one number for particularly making this particular function. If you don't have number 2, another value, not a problem at all. Okay, but you should have minimum one value. Close bracket, enter. Now, just select this cell. Bring the cursor to the corner, do double click, or else click Control C, come down, shift, hold the shift, and select until here, press enter. Anything is fine. Either you can do double click, or you can do drag and drop, or you can copy that and come down, select that, shift down. See here. Actually, this is easy. Which one? Double click is easy. Or else drag and drop is also easy. Or else if you want, select this cell, Control C, come down here, press and hold on the shift key, down arrow mark. And then press enter. Okay, so that where you will get the total first function. Or else, one more method. See here. I have some numbers. Equals this one plus this one. Enter. So what is the total value? 65. Clear? Again, equals this one minus this one, subtraction, then equals 45 multiplied by 20. And then even I can have division also, equals this one divided by 5. So basic. And suppose 2 to the power of 5. 2 to the power of 5 equals 2 power shift 6 power of 5. 32. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So 5 times of multiplication of 2 is 32. Then again concatenate. So I'm doing this all special characters algorithms like what we use for bond mass. Addition over, subtraction is over, multiplication is over, division is over, and we are going to do concatenate, squares is over. So like NICT computer okay. So this is one more function which we use to join the several text strings, concatenate. Instead of that, even we can use that AND symbol also. NICT and computer and education. See? Okay. So now, next do, let's do like product. So instead of doing that multiplication symbol, instead of using multiplication symbol, even we can use the formula also. For example, here 7, 8, and here 2 also equals product tab number 1. Comma number 2, comma number 3. So 7 into 2 into 8. Close bracket, enter. See, one number, either number or a range, it's enough. Number 2 is optional, but I selected. Number 3 is optional, but I selected. Number 4, again, if you want to go for number 4, then you have to continue with comma. So why? Because it is there in that after number 3. They given mentioned here. So if you don't have it, that's it means close bracket, enter. Is that clear? And then next we are going to see maximum, minimum, average. So next we're going to see maximum, minimum, and average equals max. Max, use the tab key and select the function. Select the ranges. I want to find the maximum for this range, which is the maximum value from max to social. Shift plus close bracket, enter. Clear? I click here, give equals min. Minimum, use the tab key and select the particular function. Select from here to here, the range from max to social. Close bracket, enter. Select this function, double click. And then we are going to do average equals average. What is average? Returns the average arithmetic mean of its arguments, which can be numbers or names, arrays or references that contains numbers. Use tab key. So again, select the range. What is the average of this 5 subject? That will be returned here. And what is the next function we are going to see? Round. I hope everyone know what is the meaning of that round function. Right? You would have seen many places and you would have studied this particular function in maths also, right? Round offing a value. So next we are going to see that one only. See here. Come down. So here I am writing a number. So like the number is 74.875678, like this. Okay. Here we are going to do round. I want to round off this number for 2 digits after the decimal. I want to round off this number for 2 digits after the decimal. Equals round. Round rounds a number to a specified number of digits. What is that round function? Rounds a number to a specified number of digits. Just take this function, select the number, comma. I want to round off here. How many digits? For two digits. So number of digits after the decimal is two. See, after decimal, after that 74 dot, after that dot, I have two decimals, like two numbers like 8 and 7. So I mentioned here two decimals, right? Just see that what is the third decimal, third number? It is 6. So if I have the third number, if I mentioned 2, and if I have the third number like 5 or more than 5, automatically 1 will be added. Clear? See here. From here, from this place, 1 has been added. From here. Why? Because I mentioned after decimal, 2 digits. Okay. Third digit, it will see. It will see the third digit. If the third digit is either 5 or greater than 5, 1 will be added. If it is lesser than 5, nothing will be happened. Is that clear? So now, see here, next function we are going to see, trunc equals trunc. See what is trunc? Truncates a number to an integer by removing the decimal or fractional or a part of number. So round means it does round offing. After decimal, if it is more than 5 for two digits means it does round off and gives the value. Okay, truncates means, trunc means it will not do round offing and all. It will not do round off and all. So if I want two digits after the decimals, okay, so remaining everything will be removed. No round off, nothing else. Whatever is there, remaining everything will be removed. So take the function, select the number, comma, I want to round off, I want to truncate for two digits after the decimal. Same two only I'll give. So what happens? After decimal 87, after that 87, whatever the remaining numbers are there, every remaining numbers will be removed. The part of number will be cutted and removed. Is that clear? And then next we are going to see ceiling. So before we are doing the function, if you read this condition what they are given, that will be very easy. Rounds a number up to the nearest multiple of significance. Rounds a number up to the nearest multiple of significance. See, for example, I'm going for a shop to buy some product. If I'm going for a shop to buy a soap, okay, you think I'm going for a shop to buy some soap, washing soap or something. I require 25 soap. I require 25 soaps. But the person is telling, I'm not selling single. You have to buy like 4 only. As I said, 4 only you have to buy. What is my requirement? 25. But the person is telling, we are not selling like individual and all. we are selling like 25, sorry, selling like 44 only as a even numbers. Okay, so then finally either I have to choose lesser than 25, I have to go, or more than 25. I have only two options. So if I want to go less, one down means, so this is my requirement and they are selling only for like this much. So then how much will be the lesser one? How much will be the greater one? Where I can buy? The next value will be where I have to add 3 extra. Lesser will be where I have to minus 1. So right? So equals ceiling. This function will help you to find that. Rounds are number up to the nearest multiple of significance. Select this function. This is a product 25 are required. They are selling significance like 4. So what will be the next value you can purchase? However, in the fourth table, you will not get 25, right? In fourth table, you will get 25. No, you will not get 25 in the fourth table. So then what will be the next value in the fourth table if you're not getting 25? See here, 28. So you have to purchase either 28 or come down floor. Floor means what? Rounds are number down. For ceiling, rounds are number up. For floor, rounds are number down to the nearest multiple of significance. Tab. Take this function, comma, select the significance, close bracket, enter. You're having now how much? 4, right? 24. Is that clear for everyone? Until here? Clear? Okay. So next we are going to see floor function. Equals floor, rounds are number to the down, nearest multiple of significance. See, once again, I'm doing the same thing. So number is 25, comma, significance is 4. So I'm getting 24. So very simple, where you can remember, like, if I take fourth table, I will get whether 25 or not. If I take fourth table, in fourth table, I will get 25 or not. Okay. If not, what will be the next number? If 25 is not coming, means after 25, what will be the next number greater than that? Which number I will be getting? 28, right? So to find that particular function for particular value, ceiling. So floor is to find the down. Previous one, 24. And next one, very, very easy. I'm taking the value like 25 and here 4. The next function is mod. What is that mod? Just read this condition here. Returns the remainder after a number is divided by a divisor. Returns the remainder after a number is divided by a divisor. Just click on tab, select the function. If a number is divided by a divisor, what will be the remainder? Okay, if we do division, we can find the quotient. I don't want quotient, I want the remainder. Okay, if this is the number, see, number is 25, comma, divisor is nothing but 4. I am dividing the 25 by 4. So then what will be the value? The value will be like 1. Is that clear? Is it okay for everyone until here? Is it work clear for everyone? All mathematical functions. So let's see once again what and all you have done now. Sum, product, maximum, minimum, average, round, trunk, ceiling, floor, mode. These are the functions we have done now. So let me do extra another two functions. So which we have already done. The same function. I am going to repeat one more time. Rand between and rand. See here, equals RAND, rand. Returns a random number greater than or equal to 0 and lesser than 1. Evenly distributed changes on recalculations. So what happens? It is going to generate some random numbers that which are greater than 0 and lesser than 1. So take the function. See on the bottom, rand, open, close. That's it, they're given. So even I will do the same thing. Just open bracket, close bracket, enter. Then you select that cell, drag and drop, however you want. It will return the numbers randomly greater than 0 and lesser than 1. So that is nothing but called as generate random numbers, rand function. Next, let me delete this one. Equals rand between. We have seen this while doing the conditional formatting, right? Rand between. What is that? Returns a random number between the numbers you specify. You are going to specify some bottom number and top number. Between that bottom number and top number, randomly some numbers is going to be generated. Take that function. Bottom is 25, comma, top is 95. Close bracket, enter. Just generate the numbers. Clear? So what is the number given? 25 to 95. So randomly it will generate. Only to from 25 to 95. If I change the value here, 5 to 9. And if I generate, drag and drop like this. It generates only the random numbers between 5 to 9. See? So bottom value is 5. It should not go less than 5. And the top value is 9. It should not go more than 9 also. So that is nothing but called as rand between function, which generates the random numbers between what you specify as a bottom and top value. So please confirm that. Is there any doubts on the mathematical functions where I completed this much from here to here? And let me send you the file in our chat box, okay, for practice purpose. Download this file. And next we are going to see this file. Then, so the first time it got failed. Again, one more time I resended the file. Please check it out. Just download this file and keep it. And next we are going to see. Logical functions. Next, we are going to see logical functions. If, and, or, not. And with this, we are going to see something like sum if. After seeing that, count if. Average if, and same thing with if us also, like sum if us. Count if us and average if. Is that clear? So this is what next what we are going to see. Logical functions, if else, and or not. After doing that basic things, next we are going to work on a practical file. So how to do sum if, count if, average if, sum if else, count if else, average if else. And I have sent you a file in our chat box. Please download that file and keep it for your reference. Not for reference, and keep it open. We are going to work on that file. Even let me open that file. So this is a file. Okay. Have this. Okay. So open this and take 5 minutes break. Okay. After the break, let's see again. We'll continue with the if function. Okay. Take 5 minutes break. I'll come back after the break. Okay, let's continue the logical functions. Is that clear? So tell me. So my question is very simple. If is used to a single logical test, based on that value of true means it returns as good, value false means it returns as bad. So here I give an example. If 5 plus 5 is 11, if value true means it has to return me as good. If value if it is false, it has to return me as bad. So tell me whether it will return as good or bad for me. That's it. Very simple question. So even I'll do here. See here. Equals if logical test 5 plus 5 is equals to 11. This is a logical test, comma. So value if true, which is given in the square bracket. So whenever I'm using a text or criteria in Excel, then I have to mention that within the double quotes. Share. Value of good means? Value of true means good. Value of false. Value of false which is highlighting. If you're getting value false means? Bad. Equals if 5 plus 5 is equals to 11. If that is condition is true, then it has to return me as good. If that condition is wrong, then it has to return me as bad. So my result is what? Bad. Is that clear? Is it clear? So next we are going to see same if function in a one more concept. See here, we have some numbers here. Equals if, this is a logical test, equals if 5 plus 4 is equals to 9. If this condition is right, then value of true means I want to know what is the total of this range. So sum of this range. Close bracket, comma. Value of false means I want to know what is the average of this range. Close bracket. I have one more close bracket. Equals if 5 plus 4 is nothing but called as what? 9. If that particular condition, what the logical test I given, if that is right, then it has to return me what is the sum of this range. If that condition is wrong, then it has to be written what will be the average for this range. Is that clear for everyone? So tell me what will be the answer for. Anyone? Quick. Whether it is total or average. So 5 plus 4 is 9, right? It is right. So it has been done the sum for this range. See here. Same value. Is that clear? Then and see here, one more thing. Wow. Thank you, Ma. Thank you so much. At least for your reply. One of you replying for my questions. Okay. Next, see here, equals if, one more thing I'm showing. If 5 is greater than 6. If that is true, find which is the minimum value from this range. Value of true means minimum from this range. Comma. Value of false means I want which is the maximum from this range. So what it has written? 372. let me select the range only this much, and for here also let me select the range only this much. Six. So phi is greater than six, right or wrong? It's wrong. Okay, so it returns which is the maximum value from this range. So it is wrong. So whatever given, phi is lesser than six, so it is wrong condition. Value false means it has to return as maximum from the selected range. Is that clear? And then see, open the first sheet which I sent you in the chat box. I sent you right in the chat box. Open the first sheet, download that STU practical file and open the first sheet in that. So I'm not making you to suffer to enter the data somehow. From my side itself, I'm giving the file. Just open that. Okay, open the first sheet. Have you downloaded the file from the chat box? Have you downloaded? Good. So just open that, open the first sheet, click on the result. Click on the result. So here what I want to find, let me tell you. Okay, wait. Before finding that, one more function let me complete. So this is the if function. If function is over, right? So next we are going to do AND function. AND is used to do multiple logical tests. AND is used to do multiple logical test. So logical 1, logical 2, logical 3, 4, like that. But what is the problem here? AND is used to, it is used to do multiple logical test if all test are true, then it returns the value true. If any values are wrong, if any test is wrong, then it returns false. So it is used to do multiple logical tests based on that. If first all tests are true, so it is a multiple logical test. If all tests are true, all the logical tests are true, functions are logical tests or logical functions. If all logical tests are true, then it returns as true. It has the value as true. If any one goes wrong, then it returns as false. Very simple. I'm writing exam for five subjects. If I take in all five subjects pass, then my result is pass. If I got fail in any one also, then my result is fail. Is that clear? See now here, let me do equals and 5 plus. So, okay, let me do it in that Excel itself. Equals and checks whether all arguments are true and returns true if all arguments are true. Checks whether all arguments are true. So that means where I can do multiple where arguments. Okay, checks all are true and then returns true means everything is right, then only the result will be right. If any one goes wrong, then result will be false. Take that function, 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. 4 plus 7 is equal to 7, comma 3 plus 2 is equal to 6. In this, if any one value is wrong also, then the result will be false. If all are true, then will be the result will be true. So tell me whether you will get the result as true or false. Tell me what will be the result, true or false. Very good. False, because the last one is wrong, right? So equals. Let me do one more thing. And 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. And 7 plus 7 is equal to 40. Now tell me, Sneha, whether this will be true or false. Good. So this will be true. So now you clear, right? Why if function is used? If is to a single logical test, based on that, returns whether it is true or false. And is used to do multiple logical tests. Based on that, if any one goes wrong also, it returns false. If everything are true, then only it returns as true. So now come back to the first sheet. Here, we are going to find the result. So just understand my question. If the student is taken in all five subjects, 35 or greater than 35. If the student is taken in all five subjects, 35 or greater than 35, then I should get the result as pass. If not, I should get the result as fail. Is that clear? The question is clear. If the student is taken 35 or greater than 35 in all five subjects, then I should get the result as pass. If not, then I should get the result as fail. How you will do this function? How you will do, which function? So don't want how you will do. Just tell me which function we can use for solve this particular question. For solving this one, which function we can use? If or and or which one? pick. No, using if okay. Using if I can do single logical test only, no ma. I can do only one logical test using if, right? But I have five subjects. I have how many subjects? Five subjects. So I have multiple logical tests. I have to use and. If I use and, I can't return my custom text whether true or fail, like pass or fail. Why? Because and will return only true or false. Only in if I can return my custom text. Only in if. And I can't do that. But in if, I can do only one logical test. But in and, I can do multiple logical tests. So what you do, right? See here. Equals if. Take the if function. Logical test. They given if will give by default one logical test. But I have five logical tests. Which function can be used to do multiple logical tests? And function, right? Take the and function here. Take and, tab, select the first one, greater than or equals to 35. And this used to do multiple logical tests. The first one, select this, greater than or equals to 35, comma, and the second one, greater than or equals to 35, comma, third one, greater than or equals to 35, comma, fourth one, greater than or equals to 35, comma, fifth one, greater than or equals to 35. So five test, either all five subject, whether it is greater than or equals to 35, greater than or equals to 35, greater than or equals to 35, like all five subjects. So five logical tests are over. Finally, close bracket. See, you follow here. Where I just went annotations on scan. Okay, see here. Here in this place, finally, you are giving close bracket. Comma, value of true means what I should get, ma? Just tell me, value of true means what? If they have taken 35 or greater than 35 in all five subjects, then what I should get? Very good. I should get like pass. Value of false means? Value of false? Fail. Very good. See, get it? So let me post the function for you in the chat box. Just take that and verify with your work what you have done. What you have done simultaneously with me, just check it out with that, whether you are getting the result or not. Getting? So once you got that, tell me in the chat box, ma. If you're doing with me, once you are clear about this particular doubt, tell me. Done? Okay, good. So now you see, next, in this column, if the student is passed, if the result is passed, then I want to find which is the minimum value in the selected range. If the result is passed, sorry, if the result is passed, I want to find total, not minimum. Minimum is the last one. I want to find what is the total of these five subjects. If the student is passed, if the student is passed, I want here the total of these five subjects. If not, I wanted here to be fail equals if this is equals to pass. If this is nothing but equals to pass, then value of true means I want sum of all these five subjects. Close bracket. Value of false means I want just as it is fail. So if G2, if this cell in this particular column, already we find out whether they are pass or fail. Based on that, if that contains pass, then I want sum of all that five subjects. If that contains fail, then I want it just as fail. Clear? If in this five sub, if here this is contains nothing but pass means I wanted total of his five subjects. If here there is something fail, then I want as it is fail. Press enter. Pass, so 392. Same thing here. If the student is passed, I want the total of his five subjects. If he is failed, I want just as it is failed. Then equals if the student is passed, that means if this is equals to pass, then I want to know the average of is five subjects. Value of true means what? Average of five subjects. Close bracket, comma, if not, five. The same thing, only the difference is what? We are changing the formula. Instead of sum, we are using what? Average. And then equals, if the student is passed, then I want percentage, total divided by number of subjects in hundreds. Five subjects, so 500. If false means, is that clear? Then equals, if the same thing, if this is equals to pass, then I wanted to find is the maximum value in the range. Value of true means maximum from this range. If not, just fail. So is that clear? Same thing you can do for minimum also. So next, go for sheet 2. Minimum you try on your own. Next, let's go for sheet 2. In the sheet 2, see here, I have employee ID. I have a column by name employee ID, and I have a column by name employee name, and I have a column by name basic pay. So these are employee IDs and these are the employees, and their basic pay is this much. And I want to find the DA, HRA and RA, DRS allowance, house rent allowance and rent allowance like this. DA, I mentioned here, DA is nothing but 45% from the basic salary. I mentioned here, DA is nothing but 45% on the basic salary. So that means how you will find out 45% based on this percent equals basic pay on this pay means equals that into 45%. Is that clear? HRA is nothing but 10% on the basic pay equals basic pay into 10%. Clear? And here RA equals 18% basic pay on basic pay into 18%. Gross salary, sum of that basic pay, DA, HRA and RA. Total is nothing but called as what? Gross salary. So total basic and what are the allowance you are getting? DA, HRA, RA, all the allowance together is nothing but called as gross salary. And PT, professional tax, is nothing but CL. If the basic pay is greater than 15,000, PT is 200. If it is lesser than 15,000, zero. So click here, equals, if basic pay is greater than or equals to 15,000, value of true means 200. If not, 0 rupees. What is professional tax? If you are having the basic pay, 15,000 or greater than 15,000 means 200 will be the tax. If not, zero. And what is ESI? Equals, if your basic pay is greater than or equals to 15,000 means 0 rupees. If not, 1.75% on basic salary. Clear? Greater than 0 means, greater than 15,000 means 0. Lesser than means 1.75%. So it's not based on a rule, just simply to understand. There is no rule in this. Like followed the rule of our tax and everything. Next, PF equals if basic pay is greater than 15,000, then 1,800. If not, 12% on basic salary. Enter. Clear? Next, total deduction equals sum of that. What will be the deduction for your salary? PT, ESI, PF, right? Close bracket, enter. Professional tax, ESI and PF. Everything will be the deduction from your salary. So sum of all these three are deductions. So what is net salary? That is nothing but equals gross salary minus deduction. Clear? Net salary is nothing but gross salary minus deduction. Okay, so please confirm. Is it clear until here for you? For you all? Any doubts is there for the second sheet? Because second sheet is very, very easy. Just if function we are using. We are not using any other functions which are tough like this. Is it clear, ma? Second sheet. If you got stuck anywhere, just please respond. I will repeat it once again. Any doubts? Please respond in the chat box. No? Until today's concept, everything are clear. Okay. So again, the third sheet, you try in on your own. Just have a try on this. On the third sheet. Okay. If you're not getting also not a problem, just have a try on this. Okay. So this we will continue from our next class. On our next session. Okay. Clear? Okay, bye. See you all in the next class. Take care. So practice until this one.